What's going on, my peoples? Today I'm gonna be cooking up some curry chicken today. These are all the seasonings that I'm gonna be using. Is everything that's lined up over there. I might change a thing or few, so just stay tuned. I cook this a bunch of different ways, so just stay tuned. As I'm gonna cook this 100%. For you, first thing I'm gonna put all my veggies in the chicken. I already cleaned my chicken. And I washed my veggies already. So I'm gonna cut up all my veggies and put it in the chicken. And you can cut this any type of way you want to. It don't matter. At the end of the day, it's all about how it comes out when you're done cooking it, right? So right now I'm cutting up some red pepper, put in here. If you're first time joining my channel, subscribe, leave a comment. I appreciate you guys for tuning in, right? I got some sweet pepper, more sweet pepper. And I got some yellow sweet pepper also. Get it all up in here. Put some thyme in here. I'm gonna add some green pepper in here. Some green Scotch bonnet pepper. This is very hot, peoples. Very hot. But I need this nice and spicy, you know? So since I just added that hot pepper to it, I'm just thinking there's no need for the spicy curry, so I'm not gonna be using this today because that's gonna too much heat. I'm not gonna be using that spicy curry today. If you like your food really spicy, you can go ahead and use that. I'm gonna put some onions in here, and you can cut your onions any way you want to cut it. So unlike curry goat, if you was cooking like curry goat or something like that, you wouldn't add your potatoes right now. But because this cooked fairly quick, I'm gonna go ahead and add my potatoes. And you don't have to use potatoes if you don't want to. But I like potatoes in my curry chicken. It's pretty nice. So we're gonna cut this in half. Then we're going to cut it again. Cut it again and just drop it in there. Be careful when you use your knife. And this potato, I already washed it. And of course, look out for my son. He should be bombing my video any minute now, like he always does. You gotta add some garlic to it. I'm going to be adding some wide egg noodles to this, but I don't need to put it now because this only takes like 7 minutes to boil. So I'm gonna put it in the middle of the cooking process, okay? So right now, we're gonna go ahead and add our seasoning. So right now, I'm going to add me some garlic powder to this. Nice and lovely. Gonna add me some black pepper to this. Not too much of this stuff. I want to add a little accent flavor into this. Not too much of this stuff. That's enough. A little complete seasoning. And I'm gonna add just a touch of this today. Just a touch, not too much of this stuff. Just a mixture of everything so your food can be nice and lovely. Now, the curry that I'm using today, this is a very famous curry in Jamaica. It's called Better Pack. And I'm gonna be mixing that with the Grace Jamaican style curry powder. So I like to mix my curry. That's just the way I do things, you know? So let's go. I was just checking the date because I had this for a while. So we're just gonna throw the curry over the meat. It's really good curry. I'm gonna save a little bit in the bag. I'm gonna need this in a little while. I'll show you why. And then I'm just gonna put a little mild in it. I just like the mixture. See a different color? It's a different color. It's a different mixture, people. And I said I wasn't gonna put no spicy hot, but I lied. I'm gonna put a little. I just like mixing things. That's enough. So now you gotta mix it all up, get it all up in there. It's really gonna mess up your hands. You gotta wash your hands really good. It really looks like you can use some more curry. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm gonna finish the rest of this. And this looks to me like, I'm gonna wash my hands right away. You wanna keep your hands clean. This curry really messes up your hands. Sorry for not pausing that process. I just want to show you guys how quick of a meal this can be and how easy it is to do it by yourself. Looks like I'm missing a little complete seasoning in here, but so I'm gonna have to wash my hands again. It's okay, cause I wash my hands like a million times during the cooking process. It's all right. As soon as you do this, make sure you wash your hands right away. You know? That should do it. So now I got my, I got my pot on the stove. Let me take you guys over here. So I got my pot on the stove and I got it. I turned on high for a second, but I'm going to turn it back down. I'm going to pour a little bit of oil in here just to give you an idea. You can use like a cork full. But I don't need the cork. I know what I'm doing. So boom, just a little bit. Probably a little bit more. Okay. So we're gonna get this hot right now. And you can see in the pot, right? But we're gonna get this food nice and cracking right now. So I'm gonna show you guys something real quick. Turn up the stove on high. We're gonna turn it back down in a second. So we're gonna put a little bit of curry in the oil. While we getting it hot. Be careful holding the pot like this. I'm fully trained to operate in the kitchen. So your objective is, when you're cooking curry chicken, is to get the oil hot, then we're gonna be putting the chicken in the oil. Right? So the oil is getting hot. We're going to transfer the chicken in the oil. We're going to stir this up in a second. But first, we go ahead and put some water in here. So we're gonna use some of this water right away, right? What we wanna do right now, we wanna keep on mixing this up. I don't want to turn it down yet. I'll tell you when we're going to turn it down. Now, At this point, you can add a little drop of water, not too much. Just a little drop. Okay? Just follow me. Because we want to mix it up and get everything nice and going, you know? Make sure we cook this, get the seasoning nice and cooked and nice and mixed before we go ahead and cook it down, right? So at this point, we can go ahead and add a little bit more water. Smelling so lovely right now, I'm telling you. Just add a little butter to it. I'm not ready to drench it. See, the more you drench it with water, the less tasteful it's gonna be. And I know it's probably no word. Is it a word called tasteful? But just follow me. So we're trying to get that nice thickness, you know? Everybody cook this different, you know? See? You see that? See that down there? That's that natural water. That's what I was looking for. That's what I was looking for down there, right? So now that I see that, I know this is ready to cook down, you know? Let me mix it up one more time. Yeah, beautiful, beautiful. Exactly what I'm looking for. So now, I'm gonna put some water in here right now. And you don't want your water to be above your meat, right? You don't wanna kill this thing with too much water. So, see that? I'm not killing it, taking my time with it. And as you learn how to cook this, everybody got a different variation of how much water they want to put in their curry chicken, you know? It all depends how you want your gravy. Do you want it light? Do you want it thick? It's looking so nice and lovely. Oh my gosh. God is good, yo. So we're not even gonna pause. We're gonna cook this live. So if you wanna fast forward to the end, you can go ahead and fast forward. I always wanted to do one of these videos where I cook it from start to finish. No interruption. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. So at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit more water, just a little drop. Oh man, that looks like too much. But it's still good. It's not above, so I don't want it to be. So right now I'm gonna cover this. And I'm gonna turn my stove down now on medium. And I'm gonna come back in 5 minutes and check on this. Okay? So if you wanna fast forward this video to 5 minutes, you go ahead. But I'm cooking this live because I want people to get the full understanding of how long this takes to cook. Now I'm gonna get ready to add my wide noodles to this. I added noodles before, but this is the first time I'm ever adding this type of noodles to the curry chicken. Let me go ahead and give it a stir. It's cooking out nice and lovely. And I'm not going to add too much noodles to this. Just a little scrape. So we're going to get in here and mix it up. So at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I'm gonna do, right? So what I'm doing now, I wanna taste this water, the gravy, to make sure it's at where it needs to be. If I need to make any adjustments, now's the time to make it, meaning if I need to add any more seasoning, I can do so. If I need to add any water to kill some of the seasoning, I can do so at this point. So let me go ahead. Now the way I got it is perfect. So what we're doing now, we don't need to add no water or nothing. All I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add a little butter, get the gravy more, a little bit more rich, and then I'm gonna turn it down and let it just simmer down to the final stage of the cooking process. Now, we're going to go ahead, turn this on low, and we're going to let this cook down for another 10 minutes. So, go ahead. If you want to forward this video 10 minutes, you can do so. I'm just trying to show you guys the real time on how long it takes me to cook this type of stuff. Thank you. So there we go. That's all she wrote, my peoples. Fully cooked. Now, I know that was more than 10 minutes. Go ahead and give it a stir. Look at that. Nice and lovely flavor. The noodles is all fully cooked. Look at that. The potatoes is fully cooked. Everything is fully cooked. The gravy. It's a nice, thick, rich gravy. So, what I like to eat with my curry chicken is white rice. I already got my rice heated up because I cooked it earlier today. So now I'm just gonna share my food, let you guys see how it looks. Directly from the pot. That's the very best food you can have. Directly from the pot. And this is a whole chicken. I just cut it up really small. I like that rich gravy all over my rice. Look at that gravy. So I'm gonna give you guys a close up on this meal in a second. Appreciate you guys for watching this video fully. So let's get a close up.